talk about cross-country skiing. Cross-country skiing is a great sport because you don't need a mountain. All you need is a little bit of snow and skis, like these. Now, cross-country skis are a little bit different than downhill skis in a few ways. First of all, they're much skinnier. They don't have a sharp edge on the side that alpine skis use to dig into the snow. And most different is the bottom. You can see on these skis, the bottom has a little bit of a fish scale-like pattern that is used to grip the snow as you move along. The other thing that's unique about cross-country skis is that the foot is in the ski and only connected by the toe, and the heel is free to move up and down. That allows the skier to employ a jogging-like motion as they pick the ski up, move it forward and set it down to grip the snow with those fish-like scales, pull themselves forward with those scales, and move the other foot forward like they would jogging. There are a few different types of cross-country skiing events, ranging in distance from the kilometer and a half sprint to the 50-kilometer skiathlon. There are two other sports that use cross-country skiing as part of their discipline. One is the Nordic Combined, which is a combination of ski jumping and cross-country skiing. The other event is called the biathlon, which is maybe my favorite Winter Olympic sport. It combines cross-country ski racing and target rifle shooting. Competitors carry a .22 caliber rifle, that's use the pole as an example for that, that they carry on their back throughout the entire race. And they stop intermittently to shoot at targets. Competitors shoot in two different positions throughout the race. The first is a stand-up shot, just like this. Or they shoot lying down in the prone position like this. The challenge of the biathlon is balancing your high heart rate while skiing with your low heart rate while shooting. The biathlon is an exciting combination of power, precision, and endurance. Until next time, I'm Will Weible, WHAS 11 News.